Hello everyone. In this video, we will study problem D of ethical beginner contest 305. Sleep log. Okay. In the first sample, the first line is a number n. N stands for the numbers of awake time and sleep time. The first number is 0. It's a fixed value, 0. It's wake time, and the second one is sleep time, wake time, sleep time, wake time, sleep time, wake time. And the third line is a question number Q. Then here are three queries. Okay, so we get three answers. Okay. Now we can divide the data, the second line, into two groups. Zero. And here, so we can two, four, zero, and 1, 3, 2, zero, and 1, 8, zero, zero. Okay. Here is the first awake time, the second awake time. And the second line is asleep time. And the ascending line means the time for sleep. And the descending line means the time for wake. Okay. Now we see the first question. 4, 8, 0 and 1, 9, 2, 0. Okay, 4, 8, 0 is in this area. Okay, so this is the first sleep time, and this is the second sleep time, and for the last sleep time, 1, 8, 0, 0, 2, 1, 9, 1, 9, 2, 0, and here is 480. Okay. So in this case, the middle time has only one segment. In fact, in some case, it may have many segments. So we can use prefix sum to calculate the total segment of sleep time first, and then we need to calculate the first segment and the last segment. And in the for the first segment here, okay, we can compare the time of 480 with the sleep time, because this line and this line are in the same area of sleep time here, this one. So we can use we kind of compare the time with the awake time because this line between 0 and 7 and 220 here, and the second line is belong to the section of 2, 2, 3, so it's the different sections. So we can compare 480 with the sleep time in this area, and for the last time we can compare the time 1920 with the less section of awake time. This between the third and the fourth awake time, we can compare 1920 with the sleep time because this line is belong to the second and the third sleep area, and this line is belong to the third and the fourth. If here is fourth position, okay. So for the first time, we compare with the sleep time, and for the last. For the last line, we compare the time with the awake time, okay? In order to find the position quickly, we can use binary search. For example, we compare 480 with the sleep time, and we can use upper bound or lower bound to find the position of 2 seconds. So then we compare the data with the awake time. If 480 is smaller than 220, we need to calculate the sleep time. If this number is greater than this number, we don't need to calculate the sleep time. For example, if this time we change this time as 18800, so we don't need to calculate the time between 720 and 800 because this area is awake time. Okay, now let's code according this idea. Include bits using namespace std. Okay. Int main. Because an is smaller than, it's not greater than 1 billion. So we can use int. We don't need to use long. Int n and a, okay. So the maximum of n is 200,000. So the sleep segment and the awake segment is not more than 100,000. So we can define max and OK，int wake and sleep wake array for the awake time and sleep array for the sleep time。And okay, for in the okay, the count of wake array and the count of sleep array, yeah. If the index is an odd number, we input it to the wake array. If the index is an even number, we put the data in the sleep array. Okay, and we also need a prefix. Array. The prefix array stores the sleep time, so you only need to loop to the half of n. P, okay, now the first for the first line, okay. Here is 200 and no. Here is the first wake minus the zero sleep, and the first sleep time is 480, and the second sleep time is wake three minus sleep two, 120, and the last area of sleep time is okay. So the prefix sign is 480. The second is 600, and finally, the last data is 960. Okay. Wake I minus sleep I. Minus one, okay. Then okay, and the first the sum zero is zero, okay. This is the prefix sign of sleep time. Now we can debug the code and check the result. Okay, here is something wrong happens. Okay. Deleted the mark. Now, okay, sum 0, 480, 600, 960. All of the data are correct. Now we can continue to the next data. Here are some queries, some questions. Okay. Q, L, and R. Input the Q. Loop for king and input L and R stands for time. Now I need two index. Okay. Int answer is zero. Position L is we use binary search upper bound. Okay, for the first time, we need to compare it with the sleep time. Because there are two possibilities for the data. The first is in the ascending line, and the second is in the descending line. For example, 800. Okay, if we have the data of 480, we get the data in the ascending line, and if we have the data of 800, we get the data in the descending line. So these two numbers are in the same sleeping section. So we need to compare the data with the sleeping array here. So sleep and the count of sleep array is count s, then arrow minus sleep. Okay, if wake, now we, because the data is 480, we get the index position error is 2. And if the second wake, the second position of wake array is larger than error, we need to calculate the sleep time. Okay, it's greater than error. Now answer wake. Okay, this is the first segment of sleep time. Now we need to calculate the last sleep segment. If, okay. So the last data is either in this section or in this section. Both are belongs to the same awake area. Now we need to compare with the awake array position R. Upper bound. Wake. Yeah, and so now we have the data of 1920, and it's the okay. We can change the index from 0. It's 0, 1, 2, and 3. 0, 1, 2. So we use binary search method to get the position of 3. Okay, so position R is 3. Now we need to compare the number of R with the sleep. The sleep time of 1800, and its index is 2. 2 is position R minus 1. So we need to compare the data of R with the sleep 2. Okay, now if R is greater than sleep, here is position R minus 1. Now we 挺爱的。This area of sleep time, okay? Now we need the middle area of sleep time, and we need to use prefix sign to calculate this. Okay. So T, the first sign and the second sign. For this line, we need to calculate the time between 1,320 and 1,440. Okay, this we can use sum 2 minus. This is the second prefix sum. This is sum 2, okay? This is sum 3, and this is sum 1. Sum 2 minus sum. Here is sum 2. Okay? Sum 2 minus sum 1. Okay, it's. And the 2 is position R minus 1, and 1 is position 0. Okay? So, hence add sum and sum position error. And finally, we output the answer. Now we compile and run, okay? We use the first data to check. Here, 480 zero, and the last answer is incorrect. So we need to debug. Sun as wake. Okay, here. So the prefix sign is correct. Okay, arrow and R is okay. Position arrow is one. No problem. Okay. 420. In the first line, the sleeping time is 240. It's right, and the position R. Okay, it's also okay. R is 1,920, and the sleep two is okay. Here, sleep two is 1,800. So it's correct. The first line and the last line of sleeping time. Okay, now here position R is 3 minus 1, sun 2 minus sun 1, sun 2 minus sun 1, 2 is 120. It's okay. Okay, the answer is 480. It's okay, and the second is okay here. The answer is zero. It's also okay. Now we see the last is zero and 2,000 and 160. Okay. Here. RS and R minus. The answer is 360. Oh, no. Position R. Sleep. Okay, here is something wrong. Up bound, so you can we can use low bound. Okay, low bound. This is not up bound. And for this one, we can use up bound or low bound. Both are okay. And for the second position, we can only use lower bound. Okay. Now we can check again. The output result is correct. And now we use the second sample to test. Okay, 177 and 296. 296, 177. Okay, and this is 61. Now we can submit the code to test in the platform. Okay, the solution is accepted. Now we can review the technology we use to solve this problem. Here we use prefix sum, and here we use binary search. Okay. So we use prefix sum and the binary search. Now this problem has been solved. Okay. And now we finish this video. See you next time.